Good afternoon to you beautiful people out there, and welcome to another episode of A Walk with Mel. We are still chatting and catching up with artists in your local communities in the hope to inspire you and also give them the platform to showcase their talent. Today we're chatting to Celeste, who started singing at the age of 9. You wouldn't want to miss her story. Let's go find out what it's like to take a walk in her shoes. Let's meet her. Celeste, who started singing at the age of 9. I'm so excited. We already vibed before the interview. Yeah. So, I mean, you started at the age of 9. Like, yes. Please tell us, how did things start? Did you know at that age you want to sing?
And no, I did not know. What happened was I started off in church. That's where the foundation
Lovely.
Was laid.
Everyone starts there.
Yeah, I just remember a story that my mother told me when I was about 5 or 6. One day on a Sunday service, the service was on and I went to the front and I started singing, "This little light of mine,
I spend number.
I'm going to let it shine." But I felt it, man. Yo. And then in the church service that morning, so the Erip Children's Choir conductor, Rosman van Sitters, she was sitting in there. And then after the service, she asked, who's the mother, and she asked me to join the choir. But I wasn't of the age yet to join.
Yeah.
So I had to wait till I was about 9 and 10, Shame. And then I could go.
So you actually started at 5.
Yeah.
Bitchy younger. Oh, so please tell us, when did you actually become serious, like, in your music?
The evening when I sang at the Grand Arena stage, it was for the company that I work for. It's a finance company. So they had an event there, and I was part of a competition called Fame. Mm-hmm. So I got through to the top 5, and we had the opportunity to perform on the Grand Arena stage at Grand West. So when I stepped out on stage, I did Rolling in the Deep of Adele, and there was thousands of people.
Wow.
And I was just feeding of their energy, and that's when I thought, yeah, man, I can do this.
Wow, that is beautiful. And tell me, who was your biggest inspiration like this far, or inspiration with your music, and who had an impact on your growth or your career?
Firstly, I can say to my choir conductors, they had a big role in where I am today. And then apart from that, I look at a lot of India Re videos.
I
look
vibe,
at, because what I see, what is different from the performer that she is that she's so unique. And when she steps out there, her music firstly makes a lot of sense. Mm. She writes sensible music.
Sure.
The second thing is, everything is just her. She's just natural. It's no fancy long eyelashes, the whole thing. So she, for me, she's my biggest inspiration besides my life and my parents.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The people that's in your life, yeah. So please tell us, I mean, you spoke about that you performed at the Grand Arena.
Yes.
I also know that you did some things with SABC
and
at the Artscape. Please tell us about those experiences.
Yeah. Everything started when I was young. Most of the things I can't even remember.
Sure.
So when I sang with the Erip Children's Choir, we sang for the ambassadors of South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
We sang at the castle, we sang for the ABC.
Sure.
And that was in the 19 somethings.
Sure.
And then we did a lot of Artscape. We were part of a production called Carmen Barrett, mm-hmm. Where we sang with fantastic opera singers like Virginia Davids,
sure.
and those type of people.
Sure, that is beautiful, and that's obviously where you obviously get your inspiration from. And then, I mean, with each artist, there's challenges that we all face.
Yes.
I mean, what is the main challenge that you face in your singing, in the career?
For me, the worst challenge is I can't accept a no. That for me, it's not on. And so what I do is I look at people and like, you know, our Cliff Phillips, the people around me first before I go. And then I send them inboxes and no one replies.
Sure.
And then that is for me a big like, because I mean, even though they're not our dolls and all, but we still look up to them.
True.
And then they just don't reply. So that was a bit challenging for me. And the little bit that does, I appreciate that.
Sure, that is beautiful, man. Mm-hmm. And then obviously, your favorite moments this far? Like, performing? What is your favorite moment?
Yeah. One of my favorite moments was to perform with Salome Johnson.
Mm-hmm.
Pia invited me to perform with her at the All Day Jom, an outreach that she did. And apart from that, I'm in a group called The Songbirds, where I meet women like Maya Spector. She's a jazz singer. And then we go back 5 decades with Sophia Foster, those type of women.
Wow.
So I'm starting to link up with people like that.
Lovely. Speaking about jazz, what kind of genre of music do you do? Is it jazz? What is your style? What is your style?
Is there any limit?
True, eh?
I'm very versatile when it comes to style. I do a bit of everything. I don't limit myself. I like to learn different things. What I haven't done yet is rock. And then currently I've been working on house music.
That is dope. Lovely. Yeah. And then also when it comes to your music, I mean, I'm sure you write your own music.
Yes, I do.
Where do you find or draw inspiration from?
Inspiration comes from my emotions at that moment.
Sure.
When I feel something, and I think mostly from hurt, I don't really write when I'm happy. I write when I'm sad or when I'm hurt.
That's when the real stuff happens.
Yes, that's when it comes. Sometimes then I sit at work by my desk, and my manager might kill me for this, but then something just pops up, inspiration, that moment.
Artist,
and I just scream, guys, do you have a pen, please? And then they're like, pen, and I just started writing. And yes.
And I mean, as an artist, whether it's 3 a.m. in the morning, whether it's at work, 3 p.m. in the afternoon, if the idea pops up, you have to
I lose it.
Yeah, of course. And I mean, what is your vision with your music? I mean, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Is there an album coming? Like, what's next for you?
Next for me, I first need to link up with the right people.
Mm-hmm.
After that, I am looking towards first getting my single out. I'd like to finish my house song, or at least another one.
Mm-hmm.
And then album I'll start looking at from next year and the year after that.
Mm-hmm.
So
something
that is
bigger than,
yes.
Mm-hmm.
I want to perform in front of millions of people, and I would like to travel.
Awesome, yeah. And also you said you have a day job, which you all have to have here in Cape Town.
Something needs to pay.
How do you balance doing both?
Luckily, I work Monday to Friday.
Okay.
So on weekends and at night, I will sit down and learn my music. I'll play my guitar. Weekends, I have gigs, mostly on weekends. I actually perform here at the Boondocks Club sometimes as well.
Awesome, so people can actually catch
people
you here.
Catch
like
me,
what days do you normally perform here? Like, there's people that want to come support
people
you?
Come on weekends. Most of the time it's packed on Saturday or Friday evenings.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just come randomly and I'll ask Uncle Kevin, can I come play? And then, I'll come play for them. And the bikers, let's still leave the fool.
So tell me, I mean, if you look at Cape Town, a lot of people, I feel, and we all see moving away when it comes to the industry. What is your take on that as an artist in Cape Town? Is it possible for you to survive here? What's your take on that?
Okay, I think that in Cape Town, we have a lack of resources. Maybe there's places and people that we don't know. And that tends to be a setback for us as local artists or aspiring artists. And apart from that is also that most of the time it doesn't always pay the bills.
Sure.
So to live from gig to gig, and that is your bread and butter, what happens when your voice hurts and you can't make it for gig?
Exactly.
So there's a lot of things like that. So I think the main thing that people do from South Africa is that we all go overseas.
Yeah.
And I wish that there was something in South Africa for us to all work with.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Because
your full potential, Richie. And then also, I mean, any advice to young people watching, if there's people watching you today that wants to start out, any advice to them?
My advice would be that don't ever stop dreaming. I think that is the best thing. Don't curb yourself, don't limit yourself, and just go out there. Al mujahan klop op iemand se deur om 'n gig te doen. Go in there, because if people don't know about you, who is there to blame but you?
Exactly.
Go out there, put yourself out there. Not everything you get paid for, but at least people will hear your stuff.
Sure, beautifully said, man.
Yes.
And then also, if you can describe yourself as an artist, like, how would you describe yourself?
Okay, I'll describe myself humble.
I
understand that we all want the limo rides and we all want the big stage, we all want the glamour. But for me personally, when I get to where I want to be as an artist, I don't want to be synced in into that world of this glitz and glamour, the bling, the everything. I want to be different, and I want to, because I know how hard it is out there. So I would like to be the type of artist who takes time and puts it into somebody else.
True.
And I want to help somebody else grow. And it means us, it could stage us, and there's a local singer. I can be like, I'm open for me at my concert. And then they would be able to have exposure. So I would like to put a seed in somebody else.
Giving
that's
back.
The type, yeah.
Because you obviously have to work hard to get there.
That's
for
it.
Yourself.
Yes.
Any artist that you would love to work with in future? I mean, if you can choose, I mean, who would you want to work with?
I'd like to work with Lira. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to work with India Re, because I look up to her a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sophia Foster, I'm praying that, because I am meeting her at our meets every, so I'm hoping that I could work with her.
And then just the last a few ones that I want to ask you, social media, like how can people support you? SoundCloud, do you have an account? How can people get your music?
Everything is simple. I go by the name of Celeste Florence.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever they want to reach me, just search on YouTube, Celeste Florence. People can subscribe. I do covers part-time when I'm bored at home. So if you want to subscribe, YouTube, I have a Facebook page, Celeste Florence.
Mm-hmm.
Everything SoundCloud, Celeste Florence. There's a sample, a small sample of on my SoundCloud of a house song that I've done.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, they can listen to that. And apart from my music, I'm also with my cousins. They're very young, they're three boys.
Yeah.
They call the Tap Out Records.
Lekker.
So I never thought that I could rap until I sat with them one evening, and I brought them here and we had a fundraiser, and the boys were rapping. So I'm also part of their group, and
so
we rap
cool.
And we do.
So cool. And people in the community, how can they support you? I mean, you say you always perform at the Boondocks, right?
Yes,
is there
yes.
any other places that you always perform at? Where
yes,
can catch
there's
you?
Many places.
Yeah. Just name maybe one or two maybe that you have.
People can catch me firstly, I'm at Boondocks. They can catch me in town. I'm always in town. They can catch me. Oh, it's so limitless.
It's limitless. You can actually catch it everywhere. It's
just catch me on Facebook.
So you can be updated.
Yeah, you'll find, you track all my events I put on there.
Lovely stuff, man. I'm excited. And you're also going to show me actually how to play. You're going to show me. And also, obviously, have a few songs for us guys, so I'm super excited to learn how to play this guitar. Jelle moet het glo.
Oh yes,
find many talents. If you didn't know, now you know. So you're gonna be showing us some cool things.
Yes.
And yeah, people, right after this. Yes, people, like we promised, Liz is gonna be teaching me, like giving me a few tips on how to play this thing. You know, I feel so honored. Girl with many talents, and then she's also going to perform for us. So let's start with you said about the G.
Yes, the G note. So I see that you have the G with no to ready now.
Yes.
So let's see how it sounds. Can we play it?
Here we go.
Hello. Yeah. So you can play a lot of songs out of that G chord. So gooi hom net so. Yeah. Oh.
Hey, I'm all too.
That's true. And then the next chord, it's very simple. It's your A chord. So we go to the second bar.
Which is this one?
Yes, that's the second bar. And then we start off with the fourth string. So you're going to put... Okay. Just turn your arm in like that.
Okay.
And then you put it in there. So all three fingers must be in here.
Oh, in that same section.
In the same
bar. Okay.
So
and this is what is this?
That's your A.
This is your A, people. Actually, we didn't know BJ.
You have it!
Great teacher was.
So you got your A.
Cool.
So out of G and A, you can play a lot.
So when you play guitar, do you actually go from A to G? But your fingers be able to do all of
your
that?
But it takes practice. Practice, sorry?
Finger push-ups.
Yes, hello. Your finger push-ups. That's a good one.
Okay.
So you must go from G to A, and then you play your different types of music.
Okay, cool. What other, maybe a last note that I can maybe...
A last note, an easy note would be, I'll give you that A minor, so you can just check where my fingers is. So So first bar, second string, and then
first. So this is the bars, right? First bar, bars, second yeah. string. Okay, cool.
And then second bar, fourth string.
That one?
So yeah.
Oh, below.
Fourth string. So
there.
Just that two. So there you go.
It's
so
great.
Do you know whose music is always played out of this first chord?
Uh-huh.
Would be Sam Smith. Guess it's true, I'm not good at a one-night stand.
Yay!
So, he uses mostly this chord.
Tell me, who taught you this? Who taught you how to play guitar? Who taught you all of these? Because, I mean, ik is klaar hier mekaar.
Okay, to be honest, I'm self-taught. What happened is, I saw this guitar on TV, and then I thought, I want to buy me a guitar. So I bought me a guitar, and then I went to a church in the Ravensmead. But the man had me yelled the G chords.
Okay.
For the whole hour, we were just learning the G chord. And I was frustrated, and I came home, and I told my mommy, you just taught me the G the whole time.
Sure.
And then my mommy said, okay, speak to the man at church. So I spoke to Uncle Melvin at church and I asked him, is there only a book of Surya?
Yeah.
Then I got the book and the CD.
Wow.
And then I just taught myself and they showed me the different chords in the book.
Stunning.
And then I saw
that is passion, people. As you can hear, I played for in the background while she was speaking. That's how we do out here.
Yeah,
do you have a song that I can maybe sing with you that you can maybe show me?
Yes.
I don't want to play now. I don't want to show off, so I'm going to give her the
okay,
note.
Out of G, because you can play G.
Oh, G. Oh, G. And so G is?
G. There we go.
Ik moet hier bij practice.
Yeah, practice. Don't worry.
There?
So, on the first
one. No, see, the first one, yeah, and the low. Ik moet down niet die ene.
On the last one.
Last one? Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
There's your G.
Okay,
cool. So, what? You can play, you can strum it like
that. Do that.
And I will pick it. So, this you pick, this you call me. Yeah, so you play the
G. I had enough picking.
No. So out of this, we can play Someone Like You over there.
Okay.
So you play the G.
But I just do this all the time.
Yeah, you can just do that. So.
Ik zie veel daar op je stem.
stage. We never also fit in Cape Town. No. But really, I hope for the best for you, honestly, for this, because I can see that it's a passion. I mean, to go and get a book and teach yourself, I wouldn't have that patience. They get clap in the gym, my fingers is clap. You know what I'm saying? So it's definitely not for everyone. So I really hope that more doors open for you through this platform, hopefully. So any last words from you that you want to share, maybe?
Any last words is that I'm currently available to perform on weekends, so you can catch me on Facebook. And if you're looking to see how I perform, check on YouTube. There's videos on my page. And yeah, I'm available, and awesome. You can book me. You can call me, and I jam different things.
Yes, so here we go.
For different events.
So give it up.
Here's Lost Without You, Mel.
Wishing you all of the best.
Thank
you for joining us on A Walk With Mel, people. Talent in your own community. So let's support our own people. Yeah. And let's stand together and do that. That's it from me, Mel, your pal and Celeste, on A Walk With Mel.
Thank you.
First verse, and you know it does not get any worse. I got my friends and my pals singing this to us. They wish our voices bring peace on this earth. Cause in the name of Jesus Christ, we were blessed above. With gifts of singing your sorrows away, we will sing till we dry your sorrows away. Please don't cry, winds of change are blown away. And I know I don't know who you are, but I know we are family. I know we are family. I got my mother, my brother and sister and lover, family. I know we are family. Family, cause we are family, we are family, we are family. I know, but we are family. Utika wakudala, we no wandi zala. Nubushamadala wandi tia, uyabu hulela, mapinga. When you see stand was aku wandi tanda yo jengawe mama wali abulela mapinga usi stand was. I'm saying this because we family. Oh, we family. Oh, we family. Cause we family. I got joy in my heart, and you know it's a kind of feeling, followed by a sense of feeling. I got joy in my heart, I got love in my heart.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah.